Hello everyone and welcome back. Last week I had released a short on Diwali snacks and most of my friends here asked for the recipe. So here are a few tea time snack ideas that you can easily prepare at home. Muttrees are my childhood favorite, so I started by making whole wheat muttrees in two different shapes. For this, I'll take around 4 cups of whole wheat and add 2 teaspoons carom seeds or ajwain. Then goes some salt and most important ingredient, 4 to 5 teaspoons ghee. Then I'll add some crushed black pepper and mix everything well. Rub all the ingredients together between your palms and see if the dough is dry binding in the fist. Then gradually add water to make a tight puri like dough. Cover and rest the dough for 10 minutes. In the meantime, heat the oil for frying. Very recently, I had shared a detailed video on how to choose the right cookwares, talking about ceramic, stainless steel, cast iron and tri-ply cookware. I'll link that video in the description box for you to check. I'll be making muttri on the slab, so we'll clean everything before starting. From the prepared dough, I'll make muttris in 4 small batches. So I'll take 1/4 portion first and again knead the dough for 2 to 3 minutes. Now roll a thin chapati from this dough. Thin chapati will give nice and crispy muttris, which I feel taste better than the thicker ones. So to shape this one, I'll simply run a knife across and make thin strips. Then cut diagonally to adjust the length according to your liking. Thin strip ones are kids' favorite and I feel they are easy to grab too. Now all that is left is frying these thin strips in oil. When the oil heats up, start adding the muttris and don't worry about the cluster as they will automatically separate out once they fry in the oil. Heat the muttris on low-medium heat so that they cook nicely from the inside and do not burn. Till the first batch turns light golden brown, I kept the second batch ready to fry. Here is a pro tip. Don't wait for your muttris to turn brown in the oil, rather take them out as soon as you see a light camel skin color, as they keep cooking in the remaining heat even after taking out of the oil. Overcooked muttris do not look good and also they turn very hard to break. Once all the oil strains, transfer the muttris to a plate lined with tissue to remove the remaining extra oil. Now with the same dough, I'll simply change the shape of muttri to include variety. Again, make a thin chapati and poke holes in it so that the muttris doesn't fluff up like puris. Then take a cutter and make your favorite shape. Ruthvi also joined me and it brought me back to the days where I used to help mom exactly like this while making muttris. Time flies so fast. I really got emotional while editing the video, thinking soon this time will also pass. So how important is it to live every moment of life to its fullest, especially when the kids are so young? Not lying, but with Ruthvi's help, things paced up a bit. While thin strips are the best companion of tea, round shape goes well on chaat platters, dahi bade, or even as canapes during parties. The next item was dahi bhalle. I had pre-soaked urad dal and will grind it coarsely with very little water. The batter should be very thick and shall have a dropping consistency. So add water little by little. See how thick the consistency is. Now in the batter goes lots of hing, cumin seeds, salt and lots of black pepper. And now comes the real deal. Beating the batter hard. The only secret of having pillowy soft dahi bhalle that really melts in mouth is beating the batter for minimum 7 to 10 minutes. Beating helps fill the air inside the bhalle and they will taste super delicious. Now pour the dollop of batter in the oil one by one. Don't worry about the shape as they automatically takes a round shape. Just make sure that you are cooking them on medium low flame and cook for around 6 to 8 minutes while turning them regularly. As soon as they turn into light golden color, take them out and delicious bhalle gets ready. Make dahi bhalle, use them in kadi pakoda or eat them as it is with chutney They are a very versatile bites, especially for serving guests. The next matri that I had made was whole wheat methi matri, and for that I again took 2 cups whole wheat flour and 1/4 cup suji. In the spices I added black pepper, hing, salt, 2 teaspoons sesame seeds and mixed them well. Now add 3 to 4 teaspoon ghee and again mix the flour while rubbing between hands. Since this is methi matri, I added around 3 to 4 teaspoon crushed kasuri methi in it. These matris call for some extra spices, so I added some turmeric and red chili powder and again gave everything a last mix. Now it's time to add hot water little by little and make a tight dough. These are layered matris and need a thin lining in between. So for that, I took around 3 teaspoon maida and added ghee into it to make a thick paste. Then take the dough and knead it for 3 to 4 minutes before rolling it out into a chapati. After rolling very thin, layer the maida and ghee paste and fold them while layering with this paste in between. Repeat this process for at least 3 times. Making homemade food is way better than bringing store-bought items. Freshness of ingredient plays a major role in the quality of food and how it affects our body later. So even if you feel like indulging yourself in food, I suggest you opt for homemade indulgence. Now, in the end, fold the chapati and roll it only from one side and cut it into thin rectangles before frying them in oil. If you are planning to make all the varieties in one go, then I would suggest you make this one in the end as the turmeric leaves the color in the oil. And this is how super flaky and layered whole wheat matris get ready. I hope this video will be useful to my friends who needed a detailed process. Do share the feedback in the comment section below and also share which snack out of these you will definitely try. Do subscribe to the channel for more such quick cooking vlogs, and I'll see you in my next one. Until then, stay tuned and stay connected.